Hey everyone, I'm Marcos and I'm Moxie Boosted, and welcome back to another Pokemon Sword and Shield VGC 2020 video. Today, I'm actually really excited because I'm back with a PC that can edit. It turns out that I just had to change some settings on my laptop and I'm able to edit my videos as if my actual gaming PC was working. So yeah, we're back with these kinds of videos. Don't expect the other types of videos to end though. This is more of just a continuation of those with higher quality to them. But I'm also going to be doing some Pokemon Showdown Lives in the future, as well as some Battle Spot Laddering and Wi-Fi Battles, so be sure to like and subscribe so you can stay tuned for those. But today I'm going to be going over some underrated Pokemon in VGC 2020. These are Pokemon that you don't see very high usage of, and I just can't wrap my head around why. Some of these Pokemon are absolutely busted. They look like gimmicks, but they're so good and find a niche in VGC that many other Pokemon just can't achieve. So if you guys are excited for that, leave a like and subscribe. And also, I want to ask you guys a question of the day. What is a Pokemon that you think is underrated and definitely should be used more in the format? I want to know. Go ahead and comment that down below. My like goal for today is going to be 80 likes. If we can reach that, I'd really appreciate it. We'll get another video like this next week. And also, I want to thank you guys for 6,000 subscribers. We're already at like 6,100, so the growth has not stopped. So to say thank you, this weekend on Saturday, I'll be giving away Hidden Ability Indeedee, Hidden Ability Pinchurchin, and Hidden Ability Freeze Dry Lapras to celebrate this occasion. So if you guys want to be part of that, go ahead and join the Discord linked in the description, and I'll give you some more info on that there. With that out of the way, let's get into the video. Speaking of Lapras, the first Pokemon I want to talk about today is Lapras itself. Now, I have a set here that I've been running on my Parish Trap team that I know some of you guys have seen, and it is really, really useful. Lapras fills a very specific niche in this format. Dracovish is one of the most common hyper-offensive Pokemon that you'll see. It just spams Vicious Rend, and it's usually a choiced item. So once it clicks Vicious Rend, it has to switch out to change what move it's locked into. Lapras actually has the ability Water Absorb, which will grant it an immunity to that move. On top of that, it has Stab Freeze Dry, which is able to OKO Dracovish. And if you want to run the Parish Trap set like I am, this set is able to take 3 Thunderbolts from Duraludon before going down. It's a guaranteed 3-hit KO after the Aguad Berry, which is really, really nice. So that means it's easy to play around that thing, click your Protects at the right times, and it'll go down in no time. Overall, Lapras is really, really cool. When you run Brine on it, if you get damage off on other Pokemon, it's going to be able to pick up the KO since they're below 50% and the damage is doubled. So that's why I think Lapras is pretty underrated. Let me know what you guys think about it. But next up, we have another old Pokemon that is going to be Goodra. Now, Goodra has actually seen some decent usage in restricted formats before. We saw a lot of it in VGC 17. People would run Assault Vest, and I think that might be the best set for it now. Because this thing has such insane special defense with 90 HP and 150 special defense, it's able to take hits even better when you slap on that Assault Vest. On top of that, if Pokemon decide to hit it on the physical side and make contact, the ability Gooey will actually slow them down. So if you want to switch in on a Dracovish, which this thing can actually take a hit from a Dracovish, you're going to be able to slow that thing down and OKO it back with Draco Meteor. This set's also able to take a Draco Meteor from Choice Specs Modest Dragapult and OKO it back with its own Draco Meteor. And just as a general support option, Goodra also got the move Breaking Swipe, which is essentially like a physical Snarl. It's going to lower both of your opponent's attacks and make it easier for Goodra to eat hits. The rest of the moves on the set are going to be Draco Meteor, Sludge Bomb, and Flamethrower. Draco Meteor is just really, really nice for getting off some insane damage with that decent 110 special attack coming off the modest nature with max special attack. Sludge Bomb is nice for hitting the fairy types that this thing doesn't want to deal with, particularly Hatterene. And Flamethrower is nice for getting rid of Ferrothorn, which can be an issue to your team if you don't have a fire type move. Next up, we actually have what is pretty much just like the second cousin of Dracovish, which is one of the most common Pokemon in the formats. We have Dracozolt. Now, Dracozolt is really, really interesting. It's actually stronger than Dracovish, but at the cost of losing accuracy because of its ability Hustle. Now, if the other Pokemon on this list were underrated, this one is the most underrated of all, in my opinion, because Dracozolt isn't even on the damage calculator. When I looked up its name on the damage calculator, I had to actually change Dracovish's stats and typing to be able to get accurate calculations, because they actually don't have this Pokemon programmed into that calculator. That's how forgotten it is. What we're going to be running here is a Life Orb set with Hustle, Max Attack, 4 Special Defense, Max Speed with a Jolly Nature, with Dragon Claw, Bolt Beak, Aerial Ace, and Protect. Now, the reason I'm running Aerial Ace is because it's just a nice flying type move that cannot miss. So if you need to guarantee a hit, that move is going to be pretty decently strong. And if you decide to Dynamax, that move will turn into Max Airstream, which will boost your team's speed and allow Dracozolt to outspeed many more Pokemon, which will boost the power of its move Bolt Beak. It's essentially just an electric type version of Fischious Rend. So we all know that it'll double in power if Dracozolt manages to move first. Now, because Hustle grants us 1.5 times attack and Life Orb grants us 1.3 times attack, if we land any hit, this thing is going to be a nuke. This thing does major damage to so many different Pokemon. In fact, this thing is the counter to Dracovish. If you decide to run a Life Orb set and outspeed it, you will actually OKO Dracovish 100% of the time. You'll do 110% minimum. So that's really nice. Next up, if you want to KO something along the lines of a defensive Rotom Wash, you will also be able to do that. And because this thing has 75 speed, most of the time you will actually outspeed a Rotom Wash if they're running a modest nature, which a lot of them are at the moment. Some of them are timid, but Modest is still very popular, so a lot of Rotom you'll be able to OKO. Finally, this thing is also able to two-shot Tyranitar and possibly one-shot it. It's a 75% chance. Bolt Beak does a minimum of 96% to Tyranitar, meaning that this thing, which naturally outspeeds it, could just invalidate Tyranitar entirely, and that is absolutely ridiculous. The damage output of this Pokemon is insane. Unfortunately, it's lacking in the bulk department. 90 HP, 90 defense, and 70 special defense is average at best, but if you manage to support this Pokemon properly with like a Tailwind Whimsicott, it's going to be sure to put some work in for your team. Next up, we have Obstagoon, and I don't know why this Pokemon hasn't seen more usage in VGC. This Pokemon has everything it needs to succeed. It's bulky with 93 HP, 101 defense, and 81 special defense. It's fast with base 95 speed, which is very, very fast for this format. The rest of the dex is pretty like average around 80 or 90, so it's faster than most things. The only thing it's lacking is an attack stat that's like out of this world. 90 attack is pretty average, but we can boost that with this set. Flame Orb Guts with Facade. Now, Facade is given double base power once you're statused in some way, so that Flame Orb will give us that Facade boost. We're now at 140 base power Facade, and Guts will give us a 50% increase on our attack stat, meaning we're going to be doing so much damage with this move. On top of that, this Pokemon gets Obstruct, which means that if anyone targets into this Pokemon the turn it goes for Obstruct with a move that makes contact, their defense will be cut in half. We'll get our Flame Orb for free, and we'll be able to do some major damage. So this set is going to be Jolly, Max Speed, Max Attack, 4 HP, Obstruct, Knock Off, Close Combat, Facade with Guts and Flame Orb. This Pokemon can do insane amounts of damage. Facade onto a fast Rotom Wash, which you outspeed 100% of the time, is a guaranteed one-shot, doing 105% minimum. Next up, Guts Boosted Close Combat will be a two-shot onto Ferrothorn, which is really nice because Ferrothorn isn't going to be able to do much to us because of how bulky we are on the physical side. So Obstagoon is actually a pretty decent counter to steel types like Ferrothorn in the format. Knockoff's also going to be able to one-shot Dragapult, and Dragapult can't really do much to us considering that we resist all of its Dark-type attacks, and its Dragon moves are pretty lacking in the power department. Dragon Claw and Dragon Darts do average damage at best, so we're not really threatened by that. The only set that could really do a lot of damage to Obstagoon is probably going to be Modest Max Special Attack, so this thing is honestly a really nice Dragapult counter as well. So Obstagoon has every tool it needs to succeed in this format. I'd really like to see its usage stats go up a bit. I feel like its usage is going to be picked up a little bit towards the end of the format when people start to play a bit bulkier. This Pokemon's going to make an excellent wall breaker. Speaking of walls, the final Pokemon might be a surprise to you guys. It is Dottler. Now Dottler is the Route 1 bug Pokemon of this game. It's the middle stage of the Orbital line, but it has some pretty insane bulk and utility once you give it an Eviolite with max HP, max defense with a relaxed nature, and 4 special defense. The set we're running here is going to be that with Trick Room, Body Press, Recover, Reflect, Eviolite, and Telepathy. Telepathy is just nice in case you want to run an Earthquake user like, I don't know, Bellydrum, Earthquake, Snorlax, or Earthquake Excadrill. You won't be taking any damage from your partner's attacks. And also, for the damage calculations you're going to see on screen, know that the damage calculator hasn't correctly programmed Body Press. So whenever you see me using a Body Press calculation on screen, it's going to say that's Choice Band and Max Attack. Just know that Body Press uses your defense stat. So Choice Band Max Attack, when I change its attack stat to 80 like its base defense, is the same thing as an Eviolite Body Press. So with that out of the way, just know that this thing eats a crunch from Tyranitar. Tyranitar does 50% minimum, 61% maximum to this set, and Body Press is going to be an OKO on it back when we go for that. because it's four times weak to it, and we have an insane defense stat at level 50 with max defense and a relaxed nature. We are hitting 145 defense, which becomes our attack stat when we go for that body press. So this thing is a physical wall, and it's going to be able to check things like Excadrill, and it's going to check things like Tyranitar, and it even two-shots Ferrothorn, which is insane. Not only that, but this thing eats a hit from major physical threats, including Dracovish. In terms of utility, this thing makes an excellent Trick Room setter. Not many Pokemon are running Taunt at the moment because they're scared of taunting into a Magic Bounce Hatterene, stopping them from being able to go for Taunt for a couple of turns and letting the Trick Room go up for free. So most people opt to just go for sheer damage output in terms of stopping Trick Room, and if there's anything that can take damage, it's Dottler. Once you get your Trick Room off, you're probably going to be at a little bit lower of an HP stat, so being able to go for a recover is really, really nice. On top of that, Dottler also has access to both screens in Reflect and Light Screen. I opted for Reflect on this set because this metagame is very much physically oriented, so it's a lot better for this thing to have Reflect than Light Screen in my opinion. But yeah, Dottler is just insane with what it can take. I've been bodied by this thing on the showdown ladder twice already, and each time I had no idea of how to deal with it. But those are my picks for underrated Pokemon. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section down below. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video at all. If you guys want to get involved with that giveaway that I'm doing for those hidden ability Pokemon, be sure to join the Discord, which is linked in the description. Follow me on Twitch as well so you can keep up with my live streams, and subscribe to the channel, blah, blah, blah. Thank you so much for 6,000 subscribers, guys. I really appreciate it. Have a nice night, and I'll see you guys in the next video, which tomorrow I'm finally going to be uploading my Sandaconda team as a rental code, so I'll be going over a breakdown of that. Thank you so much, guys. Have a nice night. See ya.